Today we're going to talk about the DRV8825 on the SmartRamps board. In a moment, I'll explain up close how the DRV8825 is lined up on the steppers. So let me just review the steppers real quick here for you. We have our X stepper, our Y stepper, and our Z stepper. Then we have extruder 1 and extruder 2. So in a moment, I'll explain close up how the DRV8825 works. This is the underside of the DRV8825. In order to connect it to the driver ports on the smart ramps, we need to know where the enable pin is. If you look real closely over here, this is our enable pin. So in a moment, I'll show you how to line it up on the smart ramps board. Okay, we're zoomed in on the X driver portion of the board. And as you can see down here, there's an enable pin port. That's the port we want to line up with the DRV8825. So in a moment, I'll show you how we're going to do that. Okay, finally, to connect it, we have to keep in mind that we no longer need to do jumpers on any one of the steppers. So we're going to look at the bottom. We're going to find where EN is for the pin, which is right here. We're going to flip it over, and we're going to line it up over the EN pin right here and apply a little bit of thumb pressure. In a moment, I'll show you how to connect the USB to the computer and load the Marlin firmware. Okay, in order to program the smart ramps, we need to connect the serial USB. So we're going to connect the small side to the programming port on the Arduino Dua. And we're going to connect the big side to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. And in a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware. Okay, we're in the Marlin-Bugfix-2.0. So we want to open this up. We then want to go down to the Marlin folder. We want to go to the source folder. We then want to go to the core folder and open up boards.h. Next, we're going to search on Smart. And what we have here is the configuration that we want to choose, which is board_ramps_smart_EFB. We're going to copy that. Now we're going to close out of this. And we're going to go back up one folder, then another folder. And then we're going to open up marlin.ino. Okay, now we have three tabs. We have the Marlin tab, the configuration.h tab, and the configuration_adv.h, which is the advanced configuration. But we're going to be working in configuration.h. So we're going to search on motherboard. And currently what we have is board_ramps_14_EFB. We're going to paste in what we copied, being board_ramps_smart_EFB. Next thing we want to do is we want to search on step. Here we go. So what we've been looking for is default_access_steps_per_unit. And what we have here are four different configurations that we're worried about, being the X, the Y, the Z, or the first extruder being E1. But seeing how we're working on X and we're using the DRV8825, what we need to do is double the 80 to 160 because it's got twice the normal steps.
of the normal ramps board. So the board that I'm referring to would be the A4988, which only has 16 steps per increment, whereas this has 32. So we're going to double it to 160. And then what we need to do is check to see what our port is. So we need to enable COM3. And then we need to check our board. Currently it's on the Arduino Mega 2560, but it needs to be on the Arduino Dua. So we're going to scroll down to find it. There we go. We have the Arduino Dua programming port selected. So all we need to do is compile and upload with the upload button. So in a moment, I'll show you how to test this in Pronerface after I hook up an end stop and power.
Okay, we need to hook up a couple of things here. I've disconnected the USB on both sides. So first thing we want to connect is the stepper motor cable for the NEMA 17 stepper driver. Next, what we want to do is connect the end stop for X-Min. So we're going to connect the red to signal for this particular stepper and black to ground. So the end stop is now connected. It's a switch or micro switch end stop. So the next thing we want to do is we want to connect the power that is unplugged . Then we want to connect the serial USB to the small programming port down below, and then finally we want to connect the other end of the serial USB to your computer. Now keep in mind, once the power is on for the USB, you don't want to touch any of the area around here. It's okay to touch the end stop and the motor, but it's not advisable. And finally, we want to plug in the power. In a moment, I'll show you how to test this in Pronerface.
Okay, I've got Pronerface open in this folder, so we're going to click on it to open it up. We're going to connect to the printer board. First thing we're going to do is make sure that we can reach the end stop with the motor. So we're going to simulate it. So I'm going to home the x-axis and the motor is going to turn. And then I'm going to press the end stop with my finger. So here we go. Okay, now that we have the end stop where we want it, we're going to advance the x-axis by 100. And now we're going to retract by 100, or go in the opposite direction by 100.
So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.